Okay, today we're going into our Bryton Active app and finding the route on Strava that we created and uploading it to our Rider 420. So to begin, we're going to go into the Bryton Active app and making sure that our Rider 420 here, or whatever device you might be using, is powered on and already connected to the Bryton Active app, which you can see here that we're already connected. We're going to begin by going to the Course tab. And from here, you can see the third option down is Strava. We're going to go ahead and use the toggle button to enable that. After a couple of seconds, it's going to open the Strava window here. Okay, and once it loads, here you have a couple of options. We're going to log in using our email address. So we'll just type in our email here. And once you put in your information, you're going to press the log on button, which is going to bring you to the Bryton Active authorization screen. You can give the information here a read. Basically, what it's saying is that it's going to allow Bryton Active to access your Strava data in order to get the routes and put them on. So we're going to go ahead and press authorize to authorize the connection. And as soon as we do, it'll bring us back to the course tab, and you'll see that Strava is now enabled. So we're going to give it a second to load, and as soon as we do, we'll be able to go into the My Route section. Okay, so once we go into My Route, you'll see that our Strava route has now appeared with the Strava icon next to it. So we're going to go ahead and press into this, and we'll see that our route that we created on Strava is now viewable within the Bryton Active app. So from here, the first thing that we're going to do is go and we're going to select Transfer to File containing turn-by-turn information. So what this is going to do is convert our route to include turn-by-turn information that we can now view on our device. Okay, so we have the option to name the route. For this example, we're going to keep it the same and just press OK. And this will take a second to load while it puts in the turn-by-turn information. So when we go back to My Route and it loads here, you'll now see the new route that we created with turn-by-turn, with the Strava icon as well as the turn-by-turn icon next to it. So we're going to click into here, and now we're going to have the option to include POI information if we wanted to. For this example, we're not going to add POI information, but if you wanted to, we'd be able to add different types of peaks, food, emergency, or other types of information. So we'll exit out of here, and then we're going to go to the upper right hand corner and press the three dots on the screen, and we're going to choose the option Download Route to Device. This will only take a second to load while it transfers over to the Rider 420. Okay, and once it does, we're going to press OK, and we're going to move over to our Rider 420. So we're going to go into the menu and select the Follow Track option. Once we're in here, we're going to select View, and we'll now see that the route that we created is on the list. So here you can see the route that we created, and we'll be able to press OK to start and begin to follow the route. And that's it. That's how you import Strava routes from your Strava account onto your Bryton Rider 420 or other compatible device.